Hi, this is Kim from Mom's Creative Moments coming to you regarding our Advent calendar that was a gift with purchase back a couple months ago. So for those of you who were able to take advantage of that special and get this Advent calendar, I just wanted to give you some ideas of what you might want to do with the embellishments that you'll find inside each of these doors. I'm not going to give anything away ahead of time. It is an Advent calendar, so of course that means that you're going to look at each door on the given day. And but we are here on the 7th of December now, so I'm going to show you what I came up with for the first 7 days. First of all, I thought I would mention that these doors are kind of hard to open, especially if you have any kind of reinforcement on your nails like I do. So I've used this really handy dandy Fiskars tool that has a rotating blade on it, and it works really great for just getting right into the groove of each of the doors and enabling me to just kind of cut open each of the windows. Because otherwise this is kind of tricky. And you'll find that you are tearing up your Advent calendar, and it's so cute. We don't want to tear it up. So if you have something like an X-Acto knife or, you know, something with a healthy blade on it, you'll want to try to use that to kind of pop these doors open. And let's go ahead and we'll open up. Each door has a cute little compartment that protects it to keep your embellishments in the right place. And you'll notice on the first, we have a really cute little horn and an M. We're gonna set those down over here. And on the second, I'm just using my all-purpose tool to try to get in here because, just like I said, it's kind of hard on my nails. So here's door number two. And you'll notice we have a cute little E, letter E. I wonder what we could be spelling. And then a cute little bow. And here's for the third. See, I got a little bit carried away with my cutting, so my calendar's kind of the worst for wear. What do we have under number three? We have an R, M-E-R, and a snowman. Cute snowman. And the fourth is another R. Looks like we're going to have a Mary and a star. The fifth, there's the Y for Mary. We're well on the road to Happy Christmas and a cocoa mug with a peppermint stick, my favorite. Okay, and let's see, six. Six is a C. And a cute little peppermint. And seven. Seven is an H, probably for Christmas. And a cute little ornament. All right, so I'm just gonna do these videos a week at a time. So there'll be one today, and there'll be another one on the 14th and another one on the 21st. And then we'll do one that I'll release after Christmas. So if you have your Advent calendar, tune back in and you can see what we've done with them. And here we go. I'm going to fast forward. These are the embellishments that we got for days 1 through 7. We're going to keep those letters separate because we can't really use them on a card, but we'll use them on a layout. But we have these cute little embellishments. Now, I got the mat pack, and you'll know that if you have this Advent calendar, you know that all the embellishments are done along with the theme for our Joy to the World collection. So all the colors will match beautifully, all the themes will match beautifully. And if you buy the mat pack, you can make some very quick, very easy Christmas cards using these cute little embellishments. I just pulled out a little bit of our blue-green cardstock and this cute little mat and cut it to fit one of our blank cards, our blank card kits. If you don't have those, they're extremely reasonable, and you get a really, really nice box along with it that you can use as a gift box. And the whole thing is just $6.50 for 12 cards and 12 envelopes. I had to buy some at a craft store the other day, and I was really surprised to find that 12 cards and 12 envelopes were at least a dollar more, even possibly more than a dollar more at the store. So very reasonable, plus you get that really nice gift box. Anyway, so I just used that mat and I cut it accordingly, and then put a little cardstock around the or underneath it to give it a frame, and then wrote the word Merry Christmas with some hearts up here and some dots, and added the cute little snowman and the peppermint and the cup of cocoa with the peppermint stick. Then I also pulled out a mat that had a tree on it. That the mat comes with the tree and the green dots. It did not have these red dots. Those I drew in with one of my Creative Memories pens, and then used these other four embellishments as ornaments on my tree. And so this I also matted on bronze shimmer paper to give it a nice frame. And again, on our blank, a blank card. So these would make really cute Christmas cards, and I do intend to send these out to my loved ones and friends. And next week, we'll show you another couple of designs that we came up with. And in the meantime, make a couple more cards with these additional embellishments that we have. All right. Hope you have a Merry Christmas. Happy scrapping, and keep creating those wonderful creative moments.